parts of the truth. Our unity is sacred. We need to understand that our basic needs are the same as humane beings: food, clothing, shelter, medical care, and quality education. I repeat this over and over and over so that we don't get lost in all the distraction, all the division, all the classifications and categories that we have for each other. I'm first and foremost a humane being. We have common interests. We need to see that when we're united together, we have the power to actually transform the world. Now we're under corporate fascism. It's not a matter of it threatening. It's already here now. Corporations control the world. We have a tyrant Trump, a psychopath president. He's anti-humane, beyond kind of revolutionary. He's a terrorist. He's a terrorist. And the USA is the most terrorist state in the world. You know, we have the largest prison population, and I suspect a lot of our potential leadership is locked up right now. Of course, including our brother Leonard Peltier, who we seem to forget all about. I think about him every day. So, we need to see that our unity is sacred. This does not mean that we do not have differences of opinion, or different ideas or different ideologies. But it does mean that at root, at bottom, we share basic common interests, basic common needs. So, I'm doing this video to remind you about that. That a unity is sacred, but it's a unity that we need to build. We build it by sharing our ideals, sharing our opinions, and working through our differences. You know, working through our contradictions and seeing that if we don't unite as a species, not just as a race or as a tribe, but as a species, that we may become extinct in our lifetime. You have a psychopath who controls, who has the nuclear codes for nuclear warfare. Of course, North Korea is off the hook. But then Trump has threatened to nuke North Korea. So, we are not really safe with him in the White House. We need to do what we can to raise consciousness, my old mantra, and look at exhausting legal, peaceful methods of struggle, legal, peaceful methods of resistance, legal, peaceful methods of fighting back against the evil in the world. And yes, there is true evil in the world. So, we need to understand that it's okay if we debate about stuff. It's okay if we disagree. But I believe we must agree on the basics. People should be fed. People have human rights, humane rights. including the right to shelter. We consider that 25,000 plus die every day from hunger and hunger-related issues on Mother Earth. We are being attacked in visible and invisible ways. So we need to be aware, be alert, stay sober, and do what we can to reach common ground so that we can help turn around this whole evil system, get rid of it, get rid of empire, and speak out with our truth as we know it. I'm not saying no absolute truth, so don't get fixated on absolutes. Nothing is absolute and everything is relative. And depends how you were raised. I came up to the 60s. So back then we had a strong anti-war movement because the Vietnam War was going on. Now we have this idiot Trump continuing his warring ways into Afghanistan. There's reasons why Empire wants Afghanistan, because it has minerals and resources that U.S. imperialism wants to extract. Now we're letting Mother Earth just be raped with all the fracking and all the destruction that we allow going on. So fascism is allowed to stay in power and control because the people here in America are passive, because the people are divided, because the people are haters instead of lovers. We need to understand that, as corny as it sounds, or as simplistic as it sounds, love is the key for us to unify, along with basic education. I just have a cheap little Samsung tablet here, and I'm still trying to do what I can to express myself, to raise consciousness, and to help to create common ground. Don't let the fascists confuse you with BS about left wing or right wing. The truth is in the center. It's not left or right. And don't let the fascists divide you behind Democrat or Republican. Both parties are corrupt. As far as I'm concerned, I don't see anyone who I would vote for president. Certainly not Bernie Sanders. He already sold out to the Democratic Party. Certainly not Hillary Clinton just because she's a woman. She's a fascist. She's a fascist warmonger. So in a way, Trump becoming president was better than Hillary being president. We still have a psychopath in the White House. So even though we have different opinions, and you're free to think your own thoughts and have your own opinions, I'm not the boss of anything. I'm only an expert on myself, the way I see it, the way I want it. So continue to learn. Develop your cognition skills. Cognition involves our perception of reality, and then our conception of that reality in relation to meaningful action to change reality, to make it better, whatever way that we can. That could just be graffiti in an alley. That could be registering people to vote. That could be volunteering in your local community. Checking out your local shelter to see how you can help. Now I mainly work with people who seek recovery from drug addiction. This is another whole round. I got a draft of a book called Radical Recovery, and I'm still going to count on my own way to help out. To see that unity is sacred. That doesn't mean like we can't disagree. Sometimes there's going to be disunity. It means that overall we want to see unity in humanity, unity among humanity, unity beyond the illusion of nation. This whole crap about Trump's is about make America great again. When was America great? America hasn't even realized its full greatness. Same as many of us have not. So continue to evolve as a spiritual being. Continue to be open to new experiences. Get out of your comfort zone. Don't just hang around with people who look like you or who will give you your basic ideas. You know, learn to integrate with other people who have different ideas, different lifestyles. To me, racism is a psychosocial disease. Even the concept of race is a social invention. So see the unity that we share. Many people are stressed out. Many people are just trying to make ends meet, trying to pay the rent, trying to feed their families, trying to avoid being arrested, might have warrants on them. You know, so do what you can to be in unity with those in your life, those in your circle of compassion, and be open to expanding your compassion beyond your immediate family and include all of humanity. We can go state by state. We see that we're really divided right now. Divided. You're not united. In actuality, there really is no United States. We're divided in so many ways that's pathetic. And what gets me is that I know that if we continue on this road with global powers on a collision course towards extinction, as a species, we will become extinct. And people think that, you know, it's just going to go on and on and on, and like, no, it won't. Mother Earth has its way, its own power too. And it will retaliate the way that we abuse her. So today I want you to, look at people, or you know, you read what they're typing, or see a video or what. Try to find out what you have in common. Try to see that unity where you can agree on stuff. It's, you know, you can have some differences. That's human nature. But see that in essence we are one people on one planet. Call Mother Earth. If I made any sense to anybody, it's worth the time me doing this video. So maybe next video I'll do a little striptease. Just kidding. Power to the truth.